Welcome back. Today, before going to the another concept, let me see what we have learned till yet, right? So we have learned ratio of area of two triangles, PPT theorem, property of angle bisector, ratio of intercept made on a transversal by three parallel lines, test of similarity that we have completed in the last presentation, right, with 1.3. Today we'll be starting with property of area of similar triangle. So when I'm talking about property of area of similar triangle, before starting with this property, I want you to be very thorough with test of similarity, because same thing is continued over here. And yes, this is the last property of this chapter. So this is the last theorem that we'll be learning in this presentation. It is theorem of area of similar triangle, and we'll be learning problem set 1.4. Let me see what theorem states. Theorem states that when two triangles are similar, see, two triangles are given as similar, the ratio of area of those triangles equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. It means the sides which are there, which we are writing in the ratio form, will be equal to their squares. So what is given to you? First condition, let me see what is given, what you have to prove. Okay, this is very easy theorem. So let me start. What is given? Both triangles are similar. So it's a very good thing that we don't have to prove that triangles are similar. Directly it is given that triangles are similar. Now AD is perpendicular to BC, and in another diagram PS is perpendicular to QR. Okay, what you have to prove here, you have to prove that area, see, this theorem is related to area. In the previous we were just proving that triangles are similar. Here we'll be proving the area of triangle. Okay, so area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is equal to the corresponding sides, squares of corresponding sides. Okay, so corresponding sides, you know it very well how to write it. You have already learned in the previous presentation, and you have drilled the many sums related to it, right? So AB square upon PQ square equal to BC square upon QR square equal to AC square upon, yes, PR square. Okay, how to prove that the squares are equal? For that, first we'll start area of triangle. Area of triangle formula we have already learned in the first property, right, in the first presentation. What was it? Yes, half into base into height. We used to cut half, so it was base into height. So according to the first triangle, what is the base? BC, and height AD. According to the second triangle, what is the base? QR, and height PS, right? Now this we give it as condition number one. Now let me take triangles, both the triangles. Now but I am taking the half triangle. You can see triangle ABD. When I am talking about a triangle, just observe the triangle. Triangle ABD and triangle PQS. Okay, so here what is given to you in the diagram, you can see B and Q are equal to each other. It is given to you. And when I talk about the perpendicular, it means angles are 90 degrees. So here, can I say two angles, so two triangles are similar by which test? Right, AA test of similarity. So I can say both triangles are similar. Once we prove similar, what is another condition what you will do here? Yes, once you write this, you will be writing in the corresponding sides form, right? So what are the corresponding sides? Your AD upon PS equal to AB upon PQ. I am taking this because these are only required. Okay, so now, but I will say, after writing this condition 2, I can see triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, right? Before we have written ABD is similar to PQS, and here I am writing triangle ABC is similar to PQR, right? So here, when these two triangles are similar, I can write this correspondence sides. What are the correspondence sides over here? AB upon PQ equal to BC upon QR, right? So from 1, 2 and 3, what you can see and what you can infer here? Yes, BC upon QR into AD upon PS is my first condition. My second condition is AD upon PS is equal to AB upon PQ. And my third condition is AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR. You can see AB upon PQ is similar in second condition also. So can I say AB upon PQ are similar? Instead of AB upon PQ, can I say AD upon PS is equal to BC upon QR? Right or wrong? Right. Right? Now BC upon QR, right? Now I will write this in the equation number 1. So what is my equation number 1? BC upon QR into AD upon PS. So instead of AD upon PS, I can write BC upon QR. So here in the next step, I have written, instead of AD upon PS, I have written BC upon QR. You can see the last line, BC upon QR into BC upon QR, right? It means BC into BC will give you BC square, QR into QR will give you QR square. It means I can say, similarly, can I prove other corresponding sides? Yes. So by this, we have proved that corresponding sides, that is a square, ratio of squares of corresponding sides are equal. Okay, I hope you understood this theorem. After solving this theorem, we'll go to example sums. Let me see the example sums. What are the example sums given in the textbook? We are referring the textbook sums. So let me see three sums here. First one. First thing is already given. Now you will be worried how to identify that we have to use this theorem. See, 1.3 was the exercise where you have to prove that two triangles are similar, and then because of test of similarity, you have to prove that two triangles are similar, then you have to write the corresponding sides, right? Now in this, already one condition is fulfilled, that is triangles are similar. In this type of questions, triangles are always given as similar. So next I will be only to write the theorem name and to write the squares. Okay, so let me have a look. See, first question itself, triangle ABC and triangle PQR are similar. I told you it will be given. Area of first triangle is 16, area of triangle PQR is 25, then find the value of ratio AB upon PQ. Okay, so whichever ratio is given to you, you take that ratio only. So here I will say in triangle ABC and in triangle PQR, when I am writing they are similar, I will write the corresponding sides, that is AB upon PQ. Now this is a theorem of area of similar triangle which we learned 5 minutes before, that is AB square upon PQ square. Now this is a square, they have asked the area. Area is given to you. So here how to find the square? The square will go over there, will become right square root. So it will be 16 square root and 25 square root. So what is the square root of 16? 4. And what is the square root of PQ? That is 25. That is 5. Okay. So here by taking out the square root method, we got AB upon PQ equal to 4 upon 5. The sum is very easy. Too small to write, but when you are writing, I am repeating every time, you have to write the brackets. Okay, now let me move on to the second question. Ratio of corresponding sides of two similar triangles is 2:5. If the area of smaller triangle is 64, then what is the area of bigger triangle? See here, this is opposite of first question. Okay, so we assume here that the both the triangles are similar. So here we'll name it, say triangle ABC is a smaller triangle, say PQR is a bigger triangle. Okay, now you have to write triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR equal to, as they have not told you which ratio you have to take AB or PQ, write directly the numbers, that is 2 upon 5. Here you will be squaring it with the area of similar triangles, ratio of area of similar triangles formula theorem. So it will be 2 square 5 square 4 upon 25. But condition you can see, area of smaller triangle is given, that is 64. So in the next line it will be 64 upon area of triangle PQR is equal to 4 upon, yes, 25. You know the cross multiplication very properly, right? So it will be 4 into area of triangle PQR equal to 64 into 25. We'll cross multiply, we'll get the answer as 400. Now here it will be square centimeter. Why we are using square? Because area. Okay, and above everywhere you can see 64 square centimeter is given. So centimeter units is being used. Okay, so be very careful while writing the final answer. Final answer must be in a statement form and units must be written. Now let me move to the next example sum, that is given as trapezium. So let me have a look. Trapezium, the word trapezium comes, we have already solved the sums related to trapezium, right, in your previous exercise. If in trapezium ABCD, side AB is parallel to side CD, okay, that we know it very well, AC and BD intersect each other at point P. You have to prove that area of triangle of ABP upon area of triangle CPD is equal to AB square upon CD square. So to prove that both triangle area of triangle is equal to the corresponding side, we have to first prove that the both triangles are similar. Okay, now similar word is not given to you. So we'll first prove that both triangle, that is triangle APB and triangle CPD, are similar. So first, you know it very well, same condition we will use which we have used in 1.3, alternate angle and opposite angle, right? It is vertically opposite angle. Don't write here opposite. In textbook, make a correction. It's vertically opposite. It's not opposite. Vertically opposite angle. Okay. So first, I will say A and C are the vertically alternate angles. Next will be vertically opposite angle. So I will say both triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. Once we prove that both triangles are similar, I will write, with the help of theorem of area of similar triangle, their corresponding sides, that is the squares of corresponding sides, okay, that is area of triangle APB upon area of triangle CPD is equal to AB square upon CD square. I hope I am very clear. This is very easy sum. Now let me move to the exercise sums. Here when we talk about exercise sums are very easy. Once you understand the concept, you will be able to solve the sums. Okay, let me move to the exercise sums. Here, ratio of corresponding sides of similar triangle is 3:5. Then find the ratio of their areas. Sides are given. What do you have to find? Yes. Similar triangle, let me say alphabets are not given, that is a ABC or triangle PQR, nothing. So let me take the corresponding side of similar triangle be B1 and B2. So 3:5, right? B1:B2 is my 3:5. So ratio of area of triangle equal to B1 square upon B2 square equal to 3 square upon 5 square. You can write it once, whole bracket square. It will be 9 upon 25. So when I am writing the formula, it is important to write the bracket, that is theorem of area of similar triangle. Don't forget to write the brackets. See, the answer is very simple. Nothing you have to do, only you have to square the corresponding sides. Okay, now let me move to the second one. Now second question is asked like a fill-up. I feel you can solve it very easily. I have directly given you the answers of fill-up. You can have a look. This sum you can do by your own also. What has been given to you? AB is to PQ, 2 is to 3. You know the answer very well. Try to solve your sum by your own and check your answer over here. Okay, final answer is 4 upon 9. And don't forget the bracket. Let me move to the next one. Third one. If triangle ABC and PQ are similar, they are told they both are similar. Once they are proved that they are similar, it means it will be another theorem, that is theorem of area of similar triangle. Okay. Now we have given the areas of a triangle. You have to fill the box, that is you have to find the corresponding sides. Okay, see, corresponding sides, if you have to find, then it will be square. If you want to find the area of triangle, then it will be square root. So your area of square, that is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is given as 80 upon 125. If you are able to do the cancellation work here, then it is better. If you are not, then you can write 80 upon 125 as it is. But why we are doing it, why it is necessary, you can see 80 upon 125 can be further divided into 16 upon 25, which are the square root of some number. You know it very well, which numbers, right? So when I'm talking about 80 and 125, I can do the square root easily. For that, again I have to go through the LCM method and have to solve. So if you break down the number here itself, it will be very easy for you. Now 16 upon 25, square root of 16 upon 25, square root of 16 is 4 and square root of 25 is 5. So I think you can solve this sum very easily. You have to just take the square root of 16 and 25. So I can say AB upon PQ value is 4 upon 5. Don't forget the bracket theorem of area of similar triangle. Okay, are the sums easy? Yes, it is very easy. Understand the concept. Only you have to square the corresponding sides. Okay, now let me move to the fourth sum of your textbook. Again, how to identify whether we have been asked with this theorem. First word itself, they have told that both triangles are similar. This is similar what you have solved in 1.3, right? 1.3, where it was 1 upon 5 or 5 upon 1, right? Same thing you will be writing here. 9 into area of triangle PQR is equal to 16 into area of triangle LMN. If QR is 20, then find MN. 1 is missing and 1 is given to you. Okay, so here first we will cross multiply what is given to you. So 9 is on my right hand side or left hand side? Yes. Right, I will say my RHS and LHS, right? So LHS 9 will come, bring the number together and bring alphabets together, that is area of triangle LMN and area of triangle PQR, and 9 upon 16 on one side. Okay, now these are the ratios which are given to you. Now already I will start that both triangles are similar given to you. Okay, so now I will use the theorem, that is theorem of area of similar triangle, in which I will write the square of corresponding side, that is MN square upon QR square. Why I have taken MN upon QR? Because they have asked MN. So I will write MN square upon QR square. I won't use the another corresponding sides. Okay, so here it will be 9 upon 16 equal to MN square upon QR square. Now it is a square. Square will go on that side, it will become square root. So 9 square root and 16 square root is 3 upon 4. Okay. So now MN upon QR. Now QR value is given as 20. So can I write MN upon 20? Right. MN upon 20 is equal to 3 upon 4. Cross multiplied, you will get MN as 20 into 3 upon 4. That gives you how many units? 15 units. The sum is very clear, very easy. Same method which we are solving for last three sums, same method is there. Nothing to worry how to solve. You can go through with the method. See, you have to be very clear where to use a square and where you have to use a square root. Okay. Now let me move to the next sum. It is the fifth one. Fifth one is given. Area of two similar triangles are. Areas are given. So here 225 and 81. So they have used the word. If a side of smaller triangle, they have used the word smaller and bigger triangle. So but obvious, whosever area is big will consider as a bigger triangle. Whosever area is small will consider it smaller triangle. If a side of smaller triangle is 12, then find the corresponding sides of bigger triangle. You can see the sums are similar. Okay, so here again we'll use B1 and B2 respectively, because we are not using any variables here, that is ABC or PQ or any name. So here we'll use area of bigger triangle upon area of smaller triangle equal to B1 square upon B2 square. Okay, now what ratios are given to you? 225 upon 81. We will use same thing, 225. If you think, is it a square root of some number? Square of some number. So 225, I can write 15 square is 225 and 9 square is 81. B1 as it is and B2 is my 12. Right? So can you cross multiply it now? Yes, B1 equal to 15 into 12 upon 9. So final answer is B1 equal to 20 centimeter. So I can say the length of corresponding sides of bigger triangle is 20 centimeter. Take the final statement from the question itself and complete the statement. See, writing the last final statement is very important. If you forget it, you might lose your marks. So this sum is again very easy, similar sum to your fourth sum. So let me move on to the next question, question number 6. Triangle ABC and triangle DEF are equilateral triangle. By the word equilateral, it will come to your mind that angles are 60 degree. Okay. If area of triangle ABC is proportional to area of triangle DEF, they are given the ratio 1:2 and AB is 4, then find DE. So let me have a look. You can see first word itself, they are not proved that they are similar. So first we will prove them similar, then we will use theorem of area of similar triangle, and then we will square or square root, whatever will be required, will do it. Okay, so first, how to prove that both triangles are similar? I can say if the triangles are equilateral, all the angles will be 60. So angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B is congruent to angle E. By a test of similarity, I can say both triangles are similar, right? By a test of similarity. Now once I prove that the triangles are similar, can I go through with the theorem of area of similar triangle? Yes. So theorem of area of similar triangle states that AB square upon DE square. It is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle DEF equal to AB square upon DE square. Now substitute the value. 1:2 is given to you, equal to 4 square upon DE square. When you cross multiply it, you will get DE square equal to 4 square into 2. Okay, I hope you know it very well. Square will go over there, will become square root. So square root of 4 into 2 will be left. So 4 root 2 is your final answer. I'm repeating it again. DE square. Square will go over there, that is on the right hand side, will become square root. Square root 4 square into 2. Square and square root will be cancelled. So it will be only root 2. Left is 4. 4 root 2 units. I hope you understood how to write 4 root 2. If you are not going through it, you can write 8 into 2. And then again DE square will go over there, will become square root. So it will be square root of 8 into 2. So you will get same answer, that is 4 root 2 units. Okay. Now let we move to the next sum, 7th one. This is the last sum. Again this is given as an activity based question. Very easy sum. Try to understand. In the adjoining figure, segment PQ is parallel to segment DE given to you. Lines are parallel. Area of triangle PQF is 20. PF, you can see PF, yes, is equal to 2DP. Then find quadrilateral DPQE by completing the following activity. Okay, so let me see what is given to you. Whole D, when we talk about PF is given and DP is not given to you, right? So can I assume let DP be X, right? So if DP is X, so what will be your PF? Yes, 2 into DP, that is 2 into X, that is my PF is equal to 2X. Once you complete this understanding now, then the whole sum is very easy. Now let me see what is your whole DF. So when I talk about DF, DF is nothing but DP plus PF, right? That is X plus 2X will give you whole 3X. Now to find the quadrilateral DPQE, we'll first take two triangles. Which two triangles you can see here? We will take triangle FDE. It means I am taking a bigger triangle, and second one I am taking FPQ. I am repeating FDE, that is a bigger triangle, and FPQ, that is a smaller triangle. I will prove that yes, both triangles are similar. How to prove? You can see here both lines are given as parallel, that is PQ is parallel to DE. So by that I can say that D, angle D and angle P are corresponding angles. Same way, can I say E and Q are corresponding angles? So here I will write angle DEF is congruent to FPQ, corresponding angle, and FED is congruent to FQP, again corresponding angle. Therefore I can say by AA test of similarity, both triangles are similar. Once I prove that they are similar, can I use the theorem? Yes. Now find the area of triangle. Now once you get the area of both the triangle, you will able to get the quadrilateral. Okay. So here I will find area of triangle FDE upon area of triangle FPQ is equal to DF square upon PF square, that is 3x square upon 2x square. That x and x square will be cancelled, number will be squared, that is 3 square is 9 and 2 square is 4. Okay, now when I am talking about this, I got the ratio of area of both the triangle, right? Now before getting the area of quadrilateral whole, I must require at least one of the area of another triangle, right? So first I will get area of triangle FDE. I will say area of FDE of a triangle FDE is 9 upon 4 into area of triangle FPQ. I am repeating again, FDE is equal to 9 upon 4 into area of triangle FPQ. That is, FPQ is given to you as 20. So instead of FPQ, triangle FPQ, I will write 20. So 9 upon 4 into 20 is 45 square units. So now it's very easy for you to find quadrilateral DPQE. Okay, so can I say bigger triangle minus smaller triangle will give me that space of, that is, quadrilateral DPQE? Right. So here I will minus bigger triangle, that is triangle FDE, minus smaller FPQ, that is 45 minus 20 will give me 25 square units. I hope you understood this thing very easy. I hope you will be able to understand all the theorems and you will be able to solve the sums. All the sums we want in your textbook, given in your textbook to be written in your notebook. But obvious, the theorem taught today you have to write in your notebook, as well as all the sums given in this presentation you have to solve in your notebook. We will be checking it, and I hope you will be able to solve it. This all exercise you will be able to solve some basic sums of problem set also. Like fill in the blanks, you can solve very easily question number 1 of problem set. So by this I complete the presentation. Thank you, students.